Excellencies, the pandemic slowed our progress on SDGs, including SDG 3.A and the Framework Convention on Tobacco Control. We need to regain momentum. Taxes on advice are called salutary. They fund useful and beneficial purposes. Tobacco tax laws fund our poverty reduction, universal health care, and COVID-19 recovery programs. They underscore the importance of tobacco use in funding of the state's most important activities. As a source of bad health, tobacco is also a source of good through taxation. The industry has not sat on its hands, nor allowed this popular vice to go unchecked. It has created products that deliver a similar satisfaction, but with far less harm. To cover the far less harmful novel tobacco products, we passed two more excise tax laws. They ban the sale of e-cigarettes to minors and flavorings on vapor products. These laws recognize the fundamental difference between various tobacco and nicotine products and acknowledge the benefit of continuing taxation of a revenue-rich activity. On demand reduction, we are for regulation and taxation. A total ban is not in the works, nor extinction by extreme taxation. Bans would only drive operators underground and substitute smuggling. That will further enrich countries that have made tobacco a state monopoly. Why would we allow that? Smuggled cigarettes are all loss on all fronts and no gain in any. We have a lot of work ahead. We look to a COP10 where we are all face to face so we can fully engage in discussions on treaty instruments and technicalities. These complex and challenging issues demand active participation of all parties and inclusive consultations with all stakeholders. And we mean all. The updating of COP10 reports must be done with transparency in full consultation with all stakeholders so that our national experiences are all taken into account and due importance accorded each. The reports must reflect evolving and the latest scientific information. Thank you.